Welcome to another 10-Minute Tip brought to you by the Olson Group. Today we're going to talk about eliminating the tax time bomb. Okay, what is the tax time bomb? Let me tell you what it is first. You probably already know, and then we're going to cover it a little bit more. The tax time bomb is the gain in the annuity that will be taxable to someone upon the death of the annuitant slash owner. Now, there are many annuities out there that are just sitting around to be passed down. And as much as I love annuities, and believe me, you know that I do, they are not usually the best place to have your client's money when it's time for the capital transfer. So why don't we take a look first at the advantages of the annuities? Because you did a great job putting your client's money in the annuity. Number one, as the chart says, it's tax deferred. You have an opportunity to outpace inflation. It can be linked to indexes. It has income options, safety from loss, and your principal and previous gains are protected. Well, let's take a look now at the three stages of an annuity. It's really the three stages of accumulation of your client's money. First of all, the first stage of the annuity is the accumulation stage. And during that accumulation stage, we want the money to pile up and grow, take advantage of the tax deferred growth, the triple compound and triple advantages where the interest compounds as well. And it gives your client a good base so that later on, when they decide to slow down and start using retirement income, it steps in, thereby the second stage. And the second stage is the distribution slash income. That's the regular season. You see, I compare the accumulation side to really that's the preseason. If this was a sporting event, it's the preseason on the accumulation, and the distribution, it's the regular season. Now we're playing ball. The third stage, though, is what I like to call postseason. That's the transfer of annuity funds. And the postseason does come. It does come to everyone. And there are death and taxes. Those are the two certain things. But the question that you need to ask your client is, we show them the tax time bomb, somebody must pay. The annuity owner can pay now, or the beneficiary will pay later. So what's the difference? Well, the beneficiary not only pays tax on the proceeds, but this additional windfall of cash could pop them up into a higher income tax bracket. Let me give you an example. You have a man or a woman that has an annuity that's worth $150,000. Let's say they put $100,000 into this. There's a $50,000 gain. They can pay tax today. If they're in the 25% income tax bracket, they're going to pay about $12,500 in taxes. Now, when that money goes to the beneficiary, be it their kids, grandkids, charity, church, synagogue, educational institution, whatever, there's going to be taxes that will be paid. They'll pay tax on the $50,000 as well. But what if their son was in the 20% income tax bracket? This extra $50,000, this windfall, is going to boost them up into another tax bracket. So what if we can get that money to them on a tax-free basis? Well, as the slide says, is there an alternative solution? There surely is. It's capital transfer utilizing a single premium life policy. Well, as this chart says, if the money is earmarked to be passed down to another generation, the single premium life plan may be the preferred financial vehicle. What questions will your client have when you propose this concept to them? Take a look. They're going to ask you, number one, how does this work? Do I have to pay taxes now? What about surrender charges? Is it hard to qualify? What if I change my mind? What if I had an emergency due to sickness? Let's show them an example. This is an abbreviated example that I'm showing you. If you notice on the PowerPoint that I have up there right now, we have an example of a female, age 65, non-smoker, that's giving you $100,000. That's the money that's in the annuity right now, net of surrender charges, net of taxes, all of those things. Because we'll ask the life insurance company to withhold some taxes. And if they have a surrender charge, we're down to this net 100 because it's easy to work with. Well, we're also going to give them, with one of our companies, a $10,000 bonus interest payment. Day one, $10,000. That'll help to offset some taxes, and that'll also help to offset some surrender charges. So day one, they have a $220,000 death benefit. So before, they had that account passed down would have been taxable. But we have quickly, through the miracle of paper and ink, moved $100,000 over, given them a $10,000 interest rate bonus, and given them a death benefit today of $220,000. You know, one of the other questions that the client had that I mentioned, what if an emergency comes up and they need my money? What if they get sick? This has a chronic illness benefit, not a long-term care rider, a chronic illness benefit. If your client cannot perform two of the ADLs, two of the activities of daily living, they don't have to be in a nursing home, they don't have to have qualified care, they don't have to have home health care. The doctor says they can't do two of the ADLs, we're going to start paying the chronic illness benefit. And in this case, it's approximately $6,000 a month and can grow. Can grow. They'll give them that money over 33 months, leaving at least $25,000 of death benefit in the pot. So your client gives you $100,000, we give them $10,000 in interest rate bonus to either cover surrender charges, help offset them, or help pay for the taxes. We give them $220,000 in death benefit that is passed down day one upon death, tax-free, and we provide them with a $6,000 per month chronic illness benefit over a 33-month period of time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your business. And as always, until next time, good selling.